The state of Black Tennessee, that's what lawmakers from the Tennessee Black Caucus want to discuss with the public.
Lawmakers are holding town hall meetings across the entire state, including right here in Memphis. We'll tell you when and where to be there because they want to hear from you, first of all, about how the last legislative session went and what needs to happen in the future. And hear with more on that, Senator Raumesh Akbari, good to have you as always. And Representative G.A. Hardaway, good to have you
as well.
This is very ground up. Basically, instead of y'all, the caucus, saying, here's what we want to do, correct me if I'm wrong, you're asking constituents, what do you want us to do, yes or no?
You're absolutely correct. We're on a listening tour. Mm-hmm. We want to get guidance from the community, in particular, for the African-American community, which is what we advocate for. But the Black Caucus is of the mind that whatever is good for African-Americans mm-hmm. in the great state of Tennessee is good for all citizens. Mm-hmm. So we'll be listening. The areas that concern health, education, the public housing, and the public policies that deal with public safety, we'll be listening for any and all concerns, but before we get into that portion of it, our president emeritus will be handling the portion of the town hall that deals with legislation that we passed, legislation that we didn't pass, and so she'll kick that off.
So, Senator, with that in mind, what were some of the key issues from this last session, and going into the upcoming session, what would you like to see done that really can impact people right here in Memphis and Shelby County?
Well, if you give me my wish list, right? We had a lot of criminal justice reform bills. We had some bad education bills we fought back against, some good ones. And certainly we had a couple of pieces of legislation dealing with Memphis specifically in our TDZ downtown. But for the next legislative session, I think that we want to look at that voucher bill again. I don't know where we'll go with that. The school voucher bill. I mean, if you look at the circumstances under which it was passed and what it's looking like now, I'm hoping there's a contingency that we'll want to address that. But for me specifically, criminal justice reform, that's where it's at. We're spending over $1 billion on the cost of incarceration. We want to be able to, those that commit heinous crimes, put them away, but those that do not, that these low-level crimes is ruining people's lives, we want to try and address that in a meaningful
way. What about the future? We had two leaders with the Shelby County Schools on just earlier today. When it comes to the future of I-zones and especially improving schools, underperforming schools in Memphis and Shelby County, where do we stand there? What can be done to make sure students are adequately educated?
Well, I-Zone is awesome. The ASD is the one that's not performing well. And fortunately, our commissioner has decided to take a step back. They're not going to add any additional schools to the ASD. They're going to evaluate those that are going to be able to come off. But really just supporting our LEAs, giving them the funds that they need. They're not fully funded right now. I don't know that that will happen without the continuation of this lawsuit. But just giving them the support they need, giving our teachers the tools they need to be successful.
Tennessee is one of those interesting states where you also have a lot of rural school districts that need more funding as well, let's face it. But then large urban districts like Memphis do as well because many of our children are not, they don't get as much support at home as otherwise. Do we need to just say this school district needs more funding, period, and you guys don't over here, whoever it is, or can you do that?
Well, I think we played games with the BEP funding over the years. We claim that we're putting more funding into public education.
Right, but are we?
But we rework the formula and then say, now you're getting more. It's a shell game. What we need is adequate funding, but along with that are other resources. It can be technical resources. For instance, some of the rural areas still don't have access to high-speed internet.
Right,
but
right.
We expect those children to be able to compete on a global scale
right.
when they can't communicate with the rest of the world. We've got some of those same internet issues with the inner city. The infrastructure may be there, but the resources for the families right. and the supporting organizations, whether it's schools or social organizations, they don't have the resources where they can afford it. So there are some commonalities between the inner city and the rural areas that we have begun to identify. The Black Caucus and the Rural Caucus And we're going to be going forward working together on this.
Very quickly here, officer-involved police shootings, making sure the dollars are there, that they're investigated, bringing in what state police to help look into matters like this. Where do we stand on that issue?
Well, we put in tax dollars that go to the TBI, the same as the rest of the state. We deserve to be served. And our position is when there's a need in Memphis, we don't want to hear about somebody else on the other side of the state needs some TBI services. We need to adequately fund TBI so they'll have personnel that are available to conduct independent, thorough investigations that will withstand the scrutiny from the public.
All right. So when and where does the public need to come? Because if you don't speak out, you can't complain.
This is your chance, right, for sure.
Tuesday, the National Civil Rights Museum at 6 o'clock. We want to hear from you. It's open to everyone. So make sure that you get an opportunity. Come on out. We'll be there till about 8:30, and we have legislators from across the state. So this is your opportunity.
All right.
Okay. And we'll start at 6 p.m., but we're going to go until everyone's hurt.
That's true. Yeah.
Okay.
But come at 6. Don't show up at 7. All
right. Yeah, please try to be here.
That's good to see you both.
We'll be looking forward to having y'all join us.
Right. Well, thank you.
Very important.
And it will be live streamed on our Black Caucus page
right.
as well.
Okay,
yes.
Cool.
We appreciate it. All right, thank you very much.
That's awesome.